Hi. In this problem, we're going to be learning and practicing how to record transactions affecting the balance sheet. And we're working with Deliberate Speed Corporation. Deliberate Speed Corporation was incorporated as a private company. The company's accounts included the following at June 30th. Now, I want to caution you when you're doing accounting problems to always pay very close attention to dates and to read carefully. These are account balances as of June 30th. We've got all the accounts listed in alphabetical order with their amounts. However, our instructions below talk about during the month of July. So these are transactions that occur in July in A through E and account balances above that are from June 30th. Our first step in recording transactions is to analyze them, to analyze the business activity to see if it's a transaction, if it has an effect on the accounting equation, and if so, then what accounting, how it affects the accounting equation, what accounts are involved, are they increasing or decreasing, and we're going to use a form called a transaction analysis form. So our process is to picture the transaction, what's being given, and what's received. Every single transaction has at least two effects on the accounting equation. And after we record it, the left side, the assets, must equal the right side, the liabilities plus stockholders' equity. Our first transaction says that Deliberate Speed Corporation issued 4,000 shares of common stock for $400,000 in cash. Let's picture it. Deliberate Speed is receiving cash, and what they're giving is common stock. Cash is an asset, so we're going to record an increase in assets, the asset cash for $400,000, and we're going to increase common stock by $400,000. Now notice there are beginning balances here already listed. Those are the balances from June 30th that were up above here. Connect put them in for us. After recording transaction A, the left side, the assets, equals the right side, the liabilities, plus stockholders' equity, which also totals $400,000. In transaction B, Deliberate Speed borrowed $100,000 in cash from a local bank, and it's payable in 2 years. What's being received is cash. What's being given most likely will be a note, because we usually borrow money using notes. Because the note is payable in more than 1 year, it's considered a long-term note. And when we talk about notes, we refer to promissory notes, written promises to pay principal plus interest at a future date. So again, we're receiving cash, we'll increase the asset cash, and we're giving a promise to pay in writing, which is a note. And it's a long-term note because it's due in greater than 1 year. After recording that, the left side, the assets of $100,000, equals the right side, liabilities of $100,000, no effect on stockholders' equity. In transaction C, Deliberate Speed bought a building for $182,000, paid $82,000 in cash, and signed a 3-year note for the balance, which is the other $100,000. What's being received here? A building, which is an asset, so we're going to increase building by $182,000. What's being given is cash of $82,000, so we'll put minus here because cash is decreasing. And the other thing we're giving is another note, a note for the balance, the other $100,000. So when we add the assets, we have a minus $82,000 and a plus $182,000, that equals $100,000. Assets are $100,000, that equals the liabilities of $100,000. And no effect on stockholders' equity, so the left side equals the right side. In transaction D, Deliberate Speed paid cash for equipment costing $200,000. We picture what's happening. Cash is being given, that decreases. Equipment is being received, that increases. And both of those are assets. So let's show an increase to equipment and a decrease to cash. This is a transaction that affects only assets. The cash goes down, the equipment goes up by the same amount. So there's zero effect on the assets and there's zero effect on liabilities plus stockholders' equity. And then finally in transaction E, Deliberate Speed purchased supplies for $30,000 on account. Remember, on account means on credit. What's being received is supplies. What's being given is a promise to pay in the future in accounts payable. So we'll increase supplies for $30,000. We'll increase accounts payable, $30,000. Then the left side, the assets of $30,000 equals the right side, the liabilities of $30,000 plus zero effect on stockholders' equity. Again, with the duality of effects, every transaction affects at least two elements of the accounting equation, two types of assets, liabilities, or stockholders' equity items. And after recording the transaction, the assets must equal the liabilities plus stockholders' equity. The accounting equation must stay in balance. So now we're going to add down each of those columns, including the beginning balance. So assets total $254,000, supplies $37,000, buildings $282,000, equipment $318,000, and land $200,000. Accounts payable is $50,000. And notes payable, $202,000. Common stock, $580,000. And retained earnings, $259,000. If we were to add up all the assets, they would total $1,091,000. And if we were to add the liabilities and stockholders' equity, they would also total $1,091,000. Now, at this point, we could check our work to see if everything is okay. I'm fairly confident, so I'm just going to say score the answer now. And indeed, we did a fine job. Let's click on next and learn how to record things the way accountants do using journal entries. Now, a journal entry is the way accountants record business transactions. We use the rules of debit and credit. Let's review those. They're based on the accounting equation. Assets are on the left side of the accounting equation, so they are increased on the left or debit side. Liabilities and stockholders' equity are on the right side of the accounting equation, so they are increased on the right or credit side. What do we do when we need to decrease an asset, liability, or equity item? We simply do the opposite of what we do to increase it. So assets will be credited to decrease them. Liabilities and stockholders' equity will be debited to decrease those. Every single journal entry has at least one debit and at least one credit. If there's only one of each, they must equal. If there's more than one debit and credit, the total of the debits must equal the total of the credits. Let's go through our transactions now. These are the same transactions as were featured in part one. We're just recording them using journal entries. Issued 4,000 shares of common stock for $400,000 in cash. What's being received is cash. What's being given is common stock. Cash is an asset. Assets are on the left side of the accounting equation, so we increase assets by left side or debiting them. So we'll list cash and the amount in the debit column. $400,000. Common stock is a stockholders' equity type account on the right side of the accounting equation. To increase common stock, we would put them on the right or credit side. Let's take a brief moment to review the format. Connect reminds us that debits should always be entered before credits. If you have more than one debit, all the debits would be listed with the amounts in the debit column. And then credits would follow with the amount in the credit column. We usually indent a little bit here in the credit line. If you have more than one debit or credit, the total debits must equal the total credits. Every single journal entry must have at least one of each. If there's only one of each, they must match in amount. Let's record that entry. In our second entry, Deliberate Speed borrowed $100,000 in cash from a local bank, payable in 2 years. We said what was being received was cash, what was being given was a promissory note, a long-term promissory note. Cash is increasing. Cash is an asset. Assets are on the left side of the accounting equation, so we increase them on the left or the debit side. Notes payable are a liability on the right side of the accounting equation. If we want to increase them, we would put them on the right or the credit side. One debit, one credit, they equal an amount. Record entry. In transaction C, Deliberate Speed purchased a building for $182,000, paying $82,000 in cash and signing a 3-year note payable. What's being received is a building. What's being given is cash and a promissory note to pay later. Buildings are increasing. They are an asset. Assets are on the left side of the equation, so we increase assets by left-siding or debiting. Cash is going to be decreasing because we're giving cash, so we want to decrease the asset cash. Since assets are on the left side and we increase on the left or the debit side, we're going to decrease by doing just the opposite, by crediting. And in our third line, we want to increase notes payable. Notes payable is a liability on the right side of the accounting equation, so we increase by putting the amount on the right or credit side. And this is a long-term note because it's greater than a year in length. Okay, debits of $182,000, credits of $182,000. Let's record the entry. In transaction D, Deliberate Speed paid cash to buy equipment. Okay, the equipment is increasing, the cash is decreasing. They are both assets. Our debit and credit rules say assets are on the left side of the equation, so we increase assets by putting amounts on the left or debit side. So let's put equipment on the left or debit side with the amount in the left column because we want to increase equipment, and we paid cash. We're going to do the opposite to decrease assets. We're going to credit. We have one debit, one credit. The amount's equal. Let's record the entry. Our last transaction is for the purchase of supplies for $30,000 on account, which means on credit. We're going to be paying in the future. What are we receiving? Supplies. What are we giving? A promise to pay in the future. Supplies are increasing. So is our promise to pay. So are our liabilities. Okay. Supplies is an asset. Assets are on the left side of the accounting equation, so we increase on the left or the debit side. So we'll debit supplies to increase them. Our liabilities are on the right side of the accounting equation. We right side or credit to increase them. So we'll increase our liabilities, specifically accounts payable, by crediting accounts payable, and we'll record that entry. Now we can click on View General Journal if we want to see them in general journal format. This is what they'd look like in an actual general journal. We're going to end the first two parts of this problem now, and I will pick up with a second part to the same problem in which we'll be posting and then preparing a trial balance. Take care.